Answer is quite out there, which I want to share with you. It's not an answer, it's a learning. It's a process. And is actually all my failures are success in disguise. And one of the learnings from the failure gets termed as success as such. So it's so important, so important. And to give yourself permission to fail. I think that's something I really want to share with all of you. I used to be very harsh on myself when things didn't work out for me. You know, you face a writer's block and you try the story. You make a movie, after 3 years of writing, then you're casting, then you're going around with a begging bowl to get the money together, because the kind of stories I tell, normally they do not have a precedent of a formula ki aise hota hai, to aise banta hai, to aise, ye to chalne wali hai. So people are normally very scared when I go to them with a project. But yes, what people have also understood is that this part of the world is evolving and is changing by the hour. Yes, we have ourselves grounded in this beautiful culture, tradition, family values, everything. But at the same time, in our hearts, in all our hearts, and if we look at ourselves very honestly, and we look deep within, inside, there is this whole thing of wanting to be the change. Ab hum wo mane ya na mane, wo hai baat. और उस सच को हम जितनी जल्दी मान लें उतना शायद हमारा टाइम बच जाता है. कई बार ऐसा स्पेशली इन अ कैंपस लाइक दिस देर विल बी सो मच ऑफ वॉइसेस अराउंड अस, देर विल बी सो मेनी कंपनीज कमिंग स्पॉन्सरिंग यू, टॉकिंग डाउन टू यू, टेलिंग यू, यू नो दैट your life is set. Don't worry. You know, we are here to all that, and this will be your first job, and this will be your kind of take home in the very first year. All that is there. I call all that noise, because I deal with that every day. इस एक्टर को ले लो, ये स्टोरी कर लो, ये आइटम सॉन्ग डाल दो, ये कर दो, वो कर दो, हिट हो जाएगा. तो आई थिंक द लाउडेस्ट वॉइस इज द वॉइस इनसाइड यू, एंड दैट यू कैन ओनली हियर व्हेन यू काइंड ऑफ अ वेरी साइलेंट विद इन. And not getting too carried away. वो मेरी माँ हमेशा बोलती थी कि सुनो सबकी बट करो मन की. It's just one life यार, मतलब, and that's it. And let me promise you, all of us are gonna die one day. There's no question about it. And that's the whole beauty of life, that we really know that there's an end to it. You know, normally you really don't know where, what iska kya hone wala hai. Hum sabko malum hai hamara kya hone wala hai. To ab jab ye baat hi samajh mein aa gayi ki hame malum hai ki hamara kya hone wala hai. So let's live it up here. Let's have fun. Let's be selfish about it. And when I say selfish, what I mean to say is you got to really, really enjoy what you're doing. You got to really do things which challenge you, which scare you. Scare is a very good thing. You know, when you're really nervous about ye hoga ke nahi hoga, usme jyada maza aata hai. So, if you can invent, reinvent yourself time and again, and all the way, you know, education is not about ki humne yahan 4 saal kiya aur khatam ho gaya. Ye to trailer hai. पिक्चर तो अभी बाकी है. सो काफी घटिया डायलॉग है बट बोल दिया मैंने. व्हाट आई वाज ट्राइंग टू से इज दैट वाज वेरी कॉर्नी. या सो एनीवे व्हाट आई वाज ट्राइंग टू से इज द रियल लर्निंग विल रियली स्टार्ट व्हेन वी ऑल स्टेप आउट ऑफ हियर. इट्स ऑलरेडी स्टार्टेड. And that's when the education begins. Education is, I think life is such a beautiful teacher. And just go with the flow. Nothing is right now written in your destiny as such. You'll have to accept that. You will be writing it yourself. As you go along, and you'll be writing it continuously. You'll be writing it day after day. You'll be writing it year after year. You'll be writing it decade after decade. I still don't know what I'm gonna do tomorrow. When I say tomorrow, it doesn't mean kal subah. Kal mujhe maloom hai main Guwahati ja raha hu. But what I mean to say is ki I really don't know. Maybe. I suddenly find something else which I feel, hey, I need to go there and express myself. I think I found my calling. I started as a salesman. I was selling vacuum cleaners door to door. Though I was a commerce student from Shriram College. And there was a lot of campus recruitment from Hindustan Lever, Shriram. You know, those days, DCM and all these companies and advertising agencies and stuff like that. But after the first interview, I realized I don't want to sell soaps or detergents. Wo mera hai nahi. So, just to carry on and tell my parents ki I'm doing a job. I took up a job at Eureka Forbes and started selling vacuum cleaners. 3 months later, I broke the national record for the maximum sales. So, which was very simple. We were taught to sell to the families, to the housewives. And which was very difficult. Try selling something to an Indian housewife, guys. Just try. That matlab, any IIT in the world cannot teach you what that one sale call will teach you. And matlab, there were so many doors used to bang on my face. Then I realized ki, why not sell it to institutions. I went to Railway Hospital. They suddenly bought 20 machines. Then I was in Delhi. So I went to Malhotra Tent House and I told him Sadar Tent House has bought 5 machines. He said, "Mere ko 10 de de." Dosto ko bulaya to wo aise aise karke wo ho gaya. Then I realized ye to ho gaya. Abhi kya karna hai? So I was very interested in fabric, garments, fashion. You know, those days the denims which we take for granted today was a distant dream. For us, for me growing up in a middle class family in India. And so there was this fabrication unit which was stitching denims. So I joined it and I started learning the process of stitching cloth, fabric, and ended up opening a factory with a friend of mine. And which from like 20 machines grew to almost like 600 machines, and we became at the age of like 21, 22, that was pretty good. एंड माय सिंपल मॉम एंड डैड थॉट कि यार आसान है लड़ाई, ये तो बिजनेस करने लगा है, आज तक फैमिली में किसी ने बिजनेस नहीं किया। बट ऑलवेज व्हाट यूज टू इंट्रीग मी वॉज दीज बिल बोर्ड्स एडवर्ड्स एंड सो सो आई फाउंड माई सेल्फ इन एडवर्टाइजिंग एजेंसी एंड सून फाउंड माई सेल्फ इन जापान लर्निंग टू सेल कार्स एंड लोकोमोटिव बिकॉज जापान वॉज कमिंग इन टू इंडिया दैट टाइम। So a Japanese company sent me there, so I worked in a factory, I worked in a petrol pump, in a dealership, in an advertising agency. Came back, kind of Japanese-fied, and got a cushy job in an advertising agency and carried on for 2 years and one day made a film, an ad film, which kind of worked out. It was for Hero Honda, it was called Fill It, Shut It, Forget It, and made it for all of 25,000 rupees because the client was sacking us. Then I tasted blood. 6 months later, I landed in Bombay thinking I've arrived from Delhi with an ad film in my back pocket and a check of like 2 lakh rupees to make it. Cut to 5 years later, I had made 2.5 ad films. It was very difficult. But I really wanted to do that. And then things changed, economy opened up, there was a demand for all that and it carried on. Till one day I found myself making my first feature film and music video. And it failed. So coming back to the, made a movie called Lux with Amitabh Bachchan and Manoj Bajpayee and Rowena Tandon as my first film. It was quite a crazy concept. It was actually a concept which my nani used to narrate to me every night. Wo Ramayan sunati thi. And sone se pehle, she used to spoil it all. She used to say, Ram aur Ravan tumhare andar hai. She used to say, what, nani, matlab, abhi itni aapne kahani sunai, ab bol rahe ho ki Ram aur Ravan was only one person. This is all a metaphor. She said, yeah, ye sab hum kar dete, but actually it's all inside you. So I made up saying ki achha aadmi bura aadmi wo tumhare andar hai aur all that. And the movie was more a philosophy than a plot, a story. I realized that. But I really loved it. I loved going to the sets. I loved directing actors. I loved writing the plot. And I realized ye film chali kyun nahi yaar, matlab what happened, there must be something wrong. So I took a 5 year break and I started watching movies from all over the world. I watched Japanese cinema, I watched Italian cinema, French, a lot of Polish cinema, obviously Hollywood, and the cinemas of the 50s and 60s in India. And I started seeing what is storytelling. It is not about whom you've casted, it's not about ye shot aise le liya waise kar liya. It was always about expression. So what do you really want to say? What are you dying to say? Now I could be saying it through my stories and you will be saying it through your inventions, through your, you know, your own thing. That your work becomes an extension of you, there cannot be a better place. Because then you're actually not working. So I really don't go to work every day. I have no working hours. Yet I'm working 24 hours. So it's all the same. So there are no holidays. Yet every day is a holiday. So it's a crazy place to be, but it's really beautiful. So I'm from Delhi University. I went into college in 80s, early 80s. Emergency was just over. There was disillusionment with the government, the system, the corruption. I'm from Air Force Bal Bharati School. There was a MiG-21 aircraft on the foyer, uska dhancha tha. We used to play around it, get punished underneath, have a tiffin there, see the plane every day. It was became a part of my consciousness. So when MiGs were falling and there was a huge corruption scandal, and I saw the documentary called Flying Coffins on NDTV, I had to express it. It related to me because I'm from an Air Force school. So I made a movie called Rang De Basanti, where I expressed that the youth cannot be standing on the fringes, that no country is perfect, we have to make it perfect. And if we need to, we cannot point a finger, we need to just step in. Because I told the story, which I was really, things which were really disturbing me inside, I was very angry about, things which would really make me happy also, all the stupidity we used to do during college. So I took the character traits of five of my best friends. We were a group of five, we still are. Sabka ko leke ek ek character banate gaye. Aur wo kahani ban gayi and it touched a chord. And I went ahead to my nani's thing kept disturbing me. It did not work in Aks. So I made Delhi 6. Now I am from old Delhi. I was born and the first years of my life are Purani Delhi wala hu main. Aur wahan ka pin code ID is 110006. So Delhi 6. Now Delhi 6 mein it was when I was growing up, there was this, everything was peaceful, yet there was this intolerance in the name of caste, in the name of religion. So I made Delhi 6, which was a voice against that, which was very uncomfortable. It was asking direct questions to the audience. It was a bitter swill, pill. I did not sweeten the pill at all. I was coming after a huge success. I knew this was my chance to go blatantly out there and not let me express it. And I went with my eyes open, absolutely into the film. I was heartbroken, it didn't work. It was turned a flop. It was my most personal work till date, but it really didn't work. So, it didn't work. So, I said, the nani has really haunted me because in Delhi, I was a kala bandar tha, aur wo to humare andar tha, wo Ravan jo tha. So, by this time, Nani had gone and left her achar martavan for us, and she was somewhere in the universe and maybe laughing. And she had absolutely done me. So, I went ahead to express it in a different way of fighting your own demons with Bhag Milka Bhag. It became a part of a trilogy for me. When I met Milka Singh and I spoke to him. I just went to Chandigarh to meet him for a couple of hours. And there was this thought that why not tell a story around partition. I knew a bit about his life, that he had a lost childhood during the ethnic violence of 1947, where millions got displaced. And the ones who suffered the most were the children and the women. So I wanted to tell that story because I'm from Delhi. I had heard horror stories about partition and it was all that. When I spoke to Milka Singh and it was a couple of hours, I said it's not going to happen. So I went to Sector 19 market, bought a toothbrush, some pajamas. I said I'm staying in Chandigarh. And I stayed there for a week and I would walk with him every morning, go for his, he used to play golf, he still plays golf at 84. Talk to him, and I discovered that twice his eyes would go moist. Once when he would narrate that he witnessed the massacre of his family. And then the second time when he would talk about his dropping the gold medal in Rome Olympics, where he was holding the world record along with a couple of people. I said, that's my story. And then there was an immense hatred inside him against the Pakistanis because he lost his whole family there. So this was a beautiful story to tell, according to me. A man fighting his own demons, fighting himself. And then we made the film. Farhan did an amazing job. He just gave me 18 months, and every day morning at 6 o'clock we would meet and he would train and we would spend the day, and that went on for 18 months and it showed in the film. So in the film got ready, I showed it to Milkha Singh. He saw the film, he had tears in his eyes, he held my hand and he says, beta, wo, it was a stupid question to ask, ki aapko kaisa laga? Matlab, to see yourself unfold on a screen, is, it would be like, wow, what a question. Matlab, kaisa laga? Only he would know kaisa laga. So, and we had to leave it. I promised myself, I will never ask him kaisa laga. There was silence. We kept sitting. It was a theater. There were only three of us there. Then he held my hand and he says, beta, wo jitni meri nafrat thi na andar, wo aaj sab pigal gayi. So I said, chalo, ye ho gaya, matlab jo film banane ka jo nani mere ko bol rahi thi, wo third attempt mein mere ko samajh mein aaya. So it took me time. It took me 12 years to get it right. This concept of fighting your own demons and not running away from them, facing them, and the idea of change. And so I had a huge success. I had another opportunity to experiment. So I made Mirzia, which was so-called, we have, all our films are musicals, everybody is singing and dancing and jumping around the trees, but I attempted a new narrative, which did not go down well, but that story always intrigued me, about this girl called Saiwan, who sacrifices her love, who breaks Mirza's arrows, and some people say that she did it for her brothers. I said, nahin, you normally... The question for me was, why do you hurt them the most whom you love the most? And never ask a girl why. It's a, never go there. Why did you say that? Why are you doing that? It's a very complicated place to go. So let it be there. And so it was an exposition of love where one was trying to figure out, why is it, what is this illogic of romance? And I was trying a new narrative, which was the birth of the first Indian musical as such, which was, the story was narrated musically and Gulzar wrote it beautifully, almost. It turned out to be an art house film, so immediately London Film Festival grabbed it, they made it an opening film, then Busan, then Chicago Film Festival selected it as one of the musicals of the world, which my predecessors were, matlab mere se pehle wale jo the, wo sab diggaj log the, Chicago and all that, you know, Cats, and this was maybe the first Asian film to be showcased in that category. But paisa nahi kamaya. So-called, it failed. It was tough. I also personally, I had invested, so I lost some money. But it was good because the learning which I got was that I'm stretching the boundary and trying to raise the bar in my own head and trying to learn this. Is there a new narrative possible, or are we going to do the same formula? And I know for a fact that I learned it. And there is no other learning better than when you do it. You can read about it, you can learn about case studies, you can... So my mentor is somebody all of you know very well. His name is Narayan Murthy. and quite often I ask him stupid questions. So we are part of a small NGO movement also. So I asked him, Narayana sir, what is the mantra? So he said, he calls me Mehra. He said, Mehra, the mantra is that I go to a video store, to a DVD store, and I have to go there and say I want a Rakesh Om Prakash Mehra film. That was really cool, for I understood what he was saying. He said, you need to be known for your what you bring on the table, not whom you have casted, not what was your box office. Because after that Friday, Dulhada Mai films have made a lot of money for a lot of people, and that's why maybe I'm standing here also. It's very important to keep churning that, but never miss out on the other side of giving yourself the permission to fail. So yeah, I thought I'd just share that. I'm really, really happy to be here. Yeah.
Thank you so much, sir.